In 2016, Scott Kelly set a record for the longest space mission by an American astronaut. During his 340 days on the International Space Station, Kelly conducted science experiments, maintained equipment, and took pictures, thousands of them. His new book, Infinite Wonder, showcases his photography. He spoke with me recently from Washington, D.C. about his new book and how he's feeling after spending nearly a year in space. Scott Kelly, thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, you're very welcome.
So most people probably know you as a record-setting astronaut. Fewer probably know that you are also a photographer. I mean, is photography something that you've always been interested in?
You know, not always. I became an astronaut in 1996, and that was, you know, a few years before everyone had a camera in their pocket at all times. So, you know, I think before then, you know, photography was something I maybe did on vacation a little bit. But as an astronaut, photography is a really big part of your job, because we take pictures for scientific reasons, we take pictures for engineering reasons, and then we take, you know, photos to, you know, share with the public what we're doing in space. So, you know, it became part of my job, and I, you know, became interested in it, but really as a result of flying in space.
The book is called Infinite Wonder. I mean, what were you trying to capture? What story are you trying to tell?
Well, you know, I think the book has three sections. It talks about the mission of flying in space. And there's a section called The Natural World, which is pictures of the Earth or space that you can kind of recognize what they are. And then the last section is a section that we call Earth Art, how you can take photos of the Earth and really make it look like a wall-worthy piece of artwork.
You write in the book about the first time you launched into space and you looked down on Earth. I mean, you are one of the few human beings who will ever be able to see Earth from this vantage point. Can you describe in words how it feels to see the Earth from there?
Yeah, so, you know, my first flight, we launched at night. It being my first mission, even on my second mission when I was the commander of the space shuttle, I didn't look out the window during ascent really one time, because I was kind of focused on my job, which was being either the pilot or the commander of the space shuttle. And on my first flight, it wasn't until we were in space for about 20 minutes that I just noticed, you know, something on the outside that caught my attention. I actually didn't even know what it is, and I asked the commander of the crew, Kurt Brown. This was his sixth flight, and I said, what's that? And he said, well, that's the sunrise. And as, you know, the sun came up, I just saw how incredibly, breathtakingly beautiful our planet Earth is. I knew right then and there I would never see anything like Earth again from space. Just, it's almost like someone took the most brilliant blue paint and just painted it on a mirror right in front of my eyes, and it was absolutely spectacular.
As you said, some of the photos in the book are of life on the International Space Station. Tell us a little bit more about your time up there. What were you doing, and what was it like to be up there for almost a year in this small space?
Well, you know, in those photos, I tried to capture, you know, a little bit of what people don't generally, you know, see on the space station, a little bit more of the mundane stuff of just, you know, living and working in space, watching TV, you know, the having a meal. You know, when you're there on the space station for a long time, our days are you know, filled with work. We do a lot of work on board the space, a lot of science experiments. Over the course of the year I was there, we had 400 different science experiments going on. So most of your time is spent either, you know, doing science, repairing the hardware that you know, fails. The space station had its 20th birthday. The first piece was launched in 1998. So, you know, you have to do a lot of maintenance, and then just the taking care of the space station stuff. But you do, you know, have a few hours every day for, you know, doing things that are just for your own enjoyment. One of the things I did was take a lot of photos.
A lot of the photos are abstract. You're almost not quite sure what you're looking at. I mean, what inspired you to take those?
Well, you know, my mother was an amateur artist, and I think I got part of her artistic brain. So I, Over time, developed a technique where I could take a close-up picture of the Earth with a really long lens, which is challenging when you're moving at 5 miles a second. So the camera has to move at a very fast but also steady rate to get an image that's in focus. And then using a software program, I would enhance the colors. I wouldn't add any colors, but just enhance them to, bring out the natural colors.
Can you talk a little bit more about how you took these pictures? Were there challenges to taking photos in outer space?
Oh, there's a lot of challenges. Not only are you moving really, really fast, so, it takes a long time to develop, to get comfortable enough in space where you have, a steady enough hand to get the pictures in focus, especially when you take pictures at night and you use, camera settings that are, you're more likely to get blurriness due to your ability to track the Earth's surface in a very steady and controlled way.
Part of the reason why you were up there for as long as you were was so that researchers could study the effects of being in space that long on your body. You've been back now for a little over 2 years. How are you feeling?
Well, I feel fine. I mean, I don't have any symptoms of being in space for that long. I still have structural changes in my eyes. Some astronauts that have spent less time in space have that as well. I mean, it's a fairly common thing that we're trying to understand. I have some genetic changes in gene expression. My understanding is 7% of my genes are expressing themselves differently, but those aren't anything that I can feel or are symptomatic. So, to answer your question, I feel fine.
Retired astronaut Scott Kelly's new book is called Infinite Wonder. Thank you so much for being with us.
Oh, thank you for having me.